look out at Christmas, at every sad face, every frown. There's more than snow that's tumbling down. There's something lacking, something we've lost on our way to all we have. What if we step out of the hustle, hustle of our lives, see what walks the field? We could be the joyful, lifting up what God has. It's so contagious that never a tear can remain. While singing Noel was Jesus' name, a heavenly chorus that lifts up a hope-filled refrain to all with ears.
Would you like to hang this one on the tree?
No, I'm showing my special one to Poppy Rufus. See, Poppy, I made it.
That's beautiful, Megan. You did that all by yourself?
Well, Mommy helped me a little.
Well, I think that's the most beautiful ornament I've ever seen. You two ought to go into business.
Mommy, wouldn't that be fun?
Yeah, it would, but, you know, we'll just have to wait till next Christmas since tomorrow's Christmas Eve. Thanks for the great idea, Poppy.
My pleasure.
I wish you could get up, Poppy. I would have you hang it for me on one of those branches way up there.
Well, sorry, kiddo, but I'm afraid your mother's going to have to take care of those branches.
Is there an ornament you'd like to hang up, Megan?
Ooh, let's do this one next. It's so pretty.
Well, not yet. This is the ornament that we put on the top of the tree.
So?
That ornament is very special. Your mother made that when she was about your age. We saved that for the last thing we put on the tree.
That's right. It's the Star of Bethlehem.
Jesus' star?
Mm-hmm.
Mommy, tomorrow's Christmas Eve. When's Christmas?
In 2 days.
Then it'll be Jesus' birthday?
That's right. And Poppy's birthday, too. You know, they were born on the same day.
Poppy, were you and Jesus twins?
Not hardly. Sometimes I feel that old, though.
Were you a disciple then?
Disciple? No, I wasn't.
Poppy, how long have you been in that wheelchair?
Well, let's see. Since you were about 2 years old. I used to be able to run and jump just like you, though.
You did?
Well, I sure did, till I hurt my leg in the war. The doctor said I'd be in a wheelchair before I was 50. 50. Well, I sure showed them a thing or two. How'd you like to take a break from decorating and how about a story from your Poppy?
Yes, yes.
Holly, honey, mm-hmm. Will you get the album from the cadenza, please?
Okay, I guess we can take a short break.
Ooh, look at that soldier. Is that you, Poppy?
Sure is. Oh, that was a long time ago. I was 22 when that was taken.
Now, you were even more handsome then. Just look at the fire in your eyes. I bet you broke a few hearts.
Well, unfortunately, I broke more than just a few. I was ready to step out and be a hero, make a name for myself.
And here's a little boy. Is that you too, Poppy?
Yes.
How come you never smiled?
She's right. There's no smiles. Now that's odd. You've always been so happy since I've known you, always giving me a wink and a smile.
Well, folks didn't smile in photographs much back then.
Even kids.
Well, anyways, let's get back here.
What's that?
That's the hospital where I was born.
It's all brown.
Well, that's just the way photos looked back then, sweetie.
That picture was taken on Christmas Day, 1915. And that's when it all started with your Poppy.
Step right up, folks. Come on, come on. That's right. Step right up. See the most amazing thing, the miracle of life.
Sorry, Mr. Miller. We've done this 1,000 times.
I hope it's a boy and he looks like me, or a girl and she looks like her mother. Or maybe it's twins, both a boy and a girl.
Oh, Lord, just one or the other. Oh! Oh.
Bring us some flowers, spread the news.
All right, everybody ready? Let's begin. Now push, push, breathe, 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 and push, push, breathe, 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 push, push, breathe, 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 push.
You can do it. We know you can do it.
Push.
You can do it. We know you can do it.
I'm gonna be a
You can do it. We know you can do it.
I'm gonna be a father.
Oh, me,
oh, my. I'm gonna be a father.
Let this child be a blessing, Lord. Let this child be great. Keep him healthy in your care. Oh, Lord, keep him safe.
boy.
A baby has been born tonight.
We'll call him Rufus.
Services at church.
Yeah.
And you kids, you stay away from that horse in the corral. He ain't broke yet. And keep an eye on your cousins, Rufus. You're the oldest.
Yes, Mama.
Rufus Miller, Rufus Miller. What are you doing here, Rufus Miller?
Throwing rocks.
Why are you throwing rocks?
Because I feel like it.
We're playing the cavalry and Indians. The girls are the Indians. They got Georgia tied to the corral.
Better tell them to stay away from that corral. That horse will either bite them or kick them. He's a devil's own.
I'm not going to tell them. They'll tie me to the corral. Georgia got loose. She don't want to play Rufus Miller?
No.
Then what do you want?
I don't want to be Rufus Miller.
You don't? Then who do you want to be, Rufus Miller?
I don't know, Jen Thorpe, Teddy Roosevelt.
Teddy Roosevelt? He's dead.
I know he's dead.
Then why do you want to be him?
Because I don't want to be me. I want to be somebody important. I want to run like the winter may charge up Salmon Hill with the sword.
Can I be Annie Oakley?
No.
Why can't I be Annie Oakley if you can be Teddy Roosevelt, Rufus Miller?
Because you can't. Why do you ask so many questions?
Then who can I be?
See?
It's just a question.
Just forget it, Sarah. Nobody remembers nothing.
Like what?
Like today is my birthday?
I forgot.
Everybody forgets all the time. That's why I want to be somebody important, like Buffalo Bill. He saved women and children in the Wild West. I want to do something like that so everyone will say, that's Rufus Miller. He did something. He's a hero.
I can say that. That's Rufus Miller, and he did something. He's a hero.
Doesn't count. I haven't been a rough rider like Teddy Roosevelt or run fast like Jen Thorpe. I've just been born and nobody remembers nothing.
Rufus, come on. We're going to play some stickball.
He doesn't want to, Nikki Barber.
Why not?
He wants to be Buffalo Bill.
Why do you want to be Buffalo Bill?
Just hush up, sir. I say I just want to be important. I want people to remember my birthday.
When's your birthday?
It's today.
Happy birthday, Rufus.
Happy birthday.
I didn't get you anything. I got some chewing gum. I chewed it already, but it's still good. Want that?
No, I want it.
Ew.
Then what do you want?
I want
to be a hero?
Yeah, I want to be a hero. I want everyone to remember December 25th as Rufus Miller's birthday. Not Santa Claus' birthday, Rufus Miller's birthday.
What about Jesus or him either?
Rufus Miller. Rufus Miller is born on December 25th, and he's somebody important. Show me a guy who's got fear in his eyes, and I'll show you a kid who's got nothing, no desire to be what a real man can be. He's afraid to stand free, but that kid won't be me, 'cause I'm gonna be a hero, the best they've ever seen. Then folks will think of Christmas and Rufus, that's me.
Occupied Poland today, a British plane flown by a volunteer American crew was shot down near Warsaw. And in other news, President Roosevelt has announced he will have another radio fireside chat with the American people.
can't. Who are you?
You must speak softly.
Where am I?
Papa, come quickly. He is awake. Get up to be quiet.
You must not yell, my friend. Please, quiet now.
I see no one.
Quiet. Wait. Quiet now.
Nothing.
How is your leg?
It's fine. Ow! Oh, no, it isn't. Oh,
it will be all right. This is my daughter, Mara. I am Yuri Yosovich. My wife, Cora, is in another part of the house. We welcome you to our home.
Where am I? I don't remember a thing. Why are we whispering?
Do you remember your name?
Well, yeah, it's Rufus. Rufus Miller. We were... Well, I'm an American, by the way.
Oh, this we were able to guess.
Mara, check on the food for our guest.
Father, we spoke of this.
Well, I'm sorry to interrupt here, but could you answer some questions? I feel a little lost.
Oh, of course you are. Mara, we will talk of this later.
But we do not have enough.
Mara, do as I say. You must forgive my daughter. These are very difficult times for us. It is hard to watch as your family is ripped apart, as they steal the innocence of our youth. I'll sit back. Try not to disturb your wounds. We found you the night before last. You were wounded and unconscious, so my daughter and I dragged you back here. We have not seen Americans here before. Does that mean there will be more coming?
Well, the United States isn't in the war effort.
I see.
I was on a British observation plane. That's the last thing I remember. Did you see the plane? Were there any other survivors?
No. No. But we must trust in God and in God's time.
Yeah, sure. Hey, where are we? This can't be a house.
Oh, it is a house. A deserted house in a deserted neighborhood. We are actually behind the walls. We hide like mice during the day and scavenge for food at night. And we wait.
Here, eat your fill.
Thank you. Oh, I'm sorry.
You fool!
Mara!
We are not all rich Americans here flying in to save the day.
You must not speak this way. That is enough.
I'm sorry.
The point is, we have not enough.
You must not speak this way. If God has delivered this young man into our protection, then protect him we will. My daughter is beginning to feel the strain. Pavel, her husband, went out for food and we do not know.
Oh, sorry. Hey, I had a duffel. Did I have a duffel?
Duffel?
It's like a bag.
Oh, yes, it's there in the corner.
Well, did you get the rations?
What?
Did you take the food?
Why do you say this? We would not steal from you.
No, no, what I'm saying is there's food. If somebody's hungry, let's break it out.
He has food? Mother, he has food.
Oh, gracious.
No, we have enough.
But he has food.
Get the bag, break it out. This will be my Christmas present to you.
We are Jews.
Oh, yeah, sure. What kind of a numbskull am I? It must have been that crack on the head that I took. But we can still have a party, right? I mean, we'll call it I'm Alive Day.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yes, thank you. Mother, if you and Mara will open some of that food, we will indeed celebrate tonight. For God has been good to us this day.
Right. Oh, thank you, no. I would have some of that soup, though. It might go a little easier on the stomach. You know, except for my leg, I seem to be pretty ship-shape.
Well, God has brought you through for his purposes, it seems.
Yeah, right.
There are two, but no dogs. It is clear. Oh, I think they were more drinkers than searchers.
Oh, praise be to God.
How do you do this?
Please?
I couldn't. Well, I don't mean to be disrespectful or nothing, but, well, I gather you're a man of the cloth or whatever you would call it. I mean, a godly man. But, well, how do you do this?
We live for God. They cannot take him away. He is our hope. His grace will see us through no matter what.
You see? This is the woman God has placed by my side. How could I ask for more? How could I not trust his judgment?
Again, no disrespect, but, well, why would God put you here if he cared? I'm sorry. Forget I asked.
No. It is a good question. Faith. What is it to have faith in God? Faith can come and go. Sometimes it is pure joy. Other times it feels impossible. But the impossible is us. We are the ones who grasp at our fears and build up our walls. That is not God. That is not God. Since I was a boy, now a man, hardship was in life, but life was in God's hand. Some today don't understand. They cry out, where is God? The world can seem empty and gray when strangers telling lies try to steal your faith away. But with all the lies that men proclaim, truth is the amazing thing. God, who carries the wind and holds the sea, this God has love enough to reach and care for me when I am crushed by all I see. He helps me to trust and know that he hears every cry of those who grieve and moves in the hearts of all with simple faith to see. I do not know why things are unfair. I don't understand the hate men share. But I know God is always, God is always there. So now, though I'm weak, I am strong, for God, who is my right, can stand against the wrong. I know not what tomorrow brings, but raise up my voice to sing of God, who carries the wind and
in the hearts of all with simple faith to see. So when my world seems cold and black, I will not doubt or turn my back. For in my heart I know it, God is always
not the opening parade for Ring Brothers and Barnum and Bailey's Circus. We need festive faces. Festive faces.
But George, we've been at this since 5, 6 o'clock this morning.
Well, we should have started at 5. That's lunch.
That's lunch.
Makeup after.
Makeup after.
Wardrobe.
Wardrobe.
We'll shoot at 3.
We'll shoot at 3.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
George, you cannot shoot that scene from that angle. It makes my nose look gargantuan.
Oh, well, it is gargantuan. She could house a family of 4 in that thing. Oh, Lucille, Lucille. You are missing the time step in the opening chorus. Let's practice. 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh. And who told her she could dance? Oh.
Did you say lunch?
Can we get some more light on camera left?
More light on camera left.
Hey, any chance there's a part in this picture for me?
Doubtful. Hey, got a turkey sandwich?
Turkey sandwich.
There's my man.
The lovely Miss Walker, the best little chorus girl in Hollywood.
And your intended, Rufie. My goodness, you never know it was Christmas Eve around here.
What's wrong, Rufus? You look like you just lost your best friend.
Nothing. Life is great. Hey, I'm in show business.
There you are. I've been looking everywhere for you. You have to take Lucille's place in the opening number.
But she's...
cursed with two left feet and the rhythm of a nun. Now, let's practice. Center stage and sparkle.
That's great, honey.
I don't care about that. Don't be sad, Rufus.
Well, that's easy for you to say. You've got a career.
I don't care about all this. I just care that you're happy. Hey, do you have a Hertz donut?
What's a Hertz donut?
Hertz donut. Oh, come on, Rufus. Things will look up.
Hey, got any beef?
Our buffalo?
I got corned beef.
That'll do.
Well, how do you want it?
What?
How?
Oh, a wise guy. We've got a real comedian here. Just give me ham on rye.
Ugh.
I'm tired of this, Ginger.
Tired of what?
This. Pushing a cart between measly acting jobs. I'm no further along than I was 3 years ago.
But you had a part in that pirate movie.
Only because I already had a limp. All I got to do was walk the plank. I didn't even have any lines. I had a bag over my head, for Pete's sake.
But you were convincing. Why, I could read the fear right through that bag. And besides, any exposure in this business is good.
To begin with, what you saw through the bag wasn't fear. I was suffocating. And how can you call having a bag over your head exposure? I need to get noticed.
You were. You were noticed.
Where?
At Schwartz's drugstore. That lady. She asked for your autograph. She recognized you.
Because of the deodorant cream ad I did for Life magazine. She only remembers me when she smells her armpits. Let's face it. Nobody wants an actor with a limp. I'm a failure.
You are not. Now, come on. You have such a handsome face, but you hardly ever smile. You really should smile more, especially now. How about some Christmas cheer?
What's there to smile about? What can I get for you?
I'll have a chicken salad with lemon. And Poopsie here, he'll have a... what's that? No, you can't have that. It hurts your tummy.
What?
He wants a pastrami, but he can't have that. It hurts his tummy.
Yes, it does. What else do you want? No. Okay.
He'll have just a limp.
Pastrami.
Yes.
Here, give him some water, too.
Miss Sullivan, they're ready for you to start.
Okay. Thank you. Come on, Poopsie. We'll eat later.
So you want to be a star, they said. Starters are standing, they said. Yeah, they're just knocking down my door.
See, Rufus, things could be worse.
Oh, Ginger, don't you see? I just want to be somebody. I need something to wrap my arms around, something to grab a hold of. Be what I was meant to be. Do what I was meant to do. I thought this was it, but... I'm just a failure here.
Now you listen to me, Rufus Miller. You are not a failure.
Okay, name one important thing I've done since I've moved out here.
You've met me.
Well, that doesn't count.
Oh, you smooth talker, you.
I'm talking about becoming famous. Being somebody that everybody knows. Everyone can look up to. Even if it's just a glossy headshot in the five and dime.
But Rufus, what does all this really matter?
What does it matter? Well, it's better than being worthless.
You are not worthless, Rufus, to me or to God. Do you hear me?
God gave up on me, Ginger.
God doesn't give up. and neither will I. Hey, if you don't like it here, let's go someplace else.
Where?
How about Indiana?
Oh, yes, Indiana, the hub of modern society.
Sure, let's do it.
What's in Indiana?
Opportunity. And my parents?
Oh, no, 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 I don't think that that's...
Rufus, we could start over. You could work in my dad's drugstore, and with your ideas, you could turn that place around. This could be the start of something great. And the people there are so friendly.
But you don't want to tie yourself down with an old sad sack like me, do you?
Miss Ginger Walker wanted on what road, Miss Ginger Walker?
Right here. You, I like. The sad, we can leave behind.
But well, what about show business and you?
If I never were chorus girl number 5 again, it would suit me fine. Besides, being Mrs. Rufus Miller is all the singing and dancing I could ever want. What do you say, Rufus? You need to get away from here, don't you? You need a dose of Christmas cheer, and there's only one place. Maybe we can go to Indiana for Christmas this year. There the snow is piling high and love is nigh, for family is near. A Christmas morning The land of opportunity.
They grow fields of opportunity, huh?
As far as the eye can see.
Well, maybe I could be mayor.
Why not?
Senator Rufus Miller.
My husband.
Or president. Well, an actor's bound to be president someday. Might as well be me.
Maybe we could go to Indiana for Christmas this year. There the snow is piling high and love is nigh, for family is near. A Christmas morning ride in a one-horse open sleigh, greeting every neighbor we meet along. Roasting in the fireplace with the kids close at hand. Once you see the joy on every face, you'll understand. A Christmas wish on the tree is there for you and me.
We could start tomorrow there.
Happy ever after. Maybe we could find it all in happiness besides in Indiana.
I like your hands, Poppy. They're so big and strong.
Well, they used to be a lot stronger, Puddin'.
Hey, are you guys going to help me finish up or not? We've got to get this done before Grandma Jen gets here.
I bet you're a strong man in the circus, Poppy.
Where do you get these things?
I bet you picked up elephants with your bare hands. Maybe even clowns.
You do you?
Yep, but that was after you were a disciple.
So it was.
Mr. Walker, I'll be just across the street in the park. Ginger wanted to have a picnic.
It's a little chilly for a picnic, isn't it? You and daughter need to show more concern for that new granddaughter of mine.
Well, actually, I was thinking more of a grandson, or son. We'll bundle up.
No, don't you know anything about childbearing? You just notice how she's carrying that child. It's a granddaughter. Now, lunch is 45 minutes.
Yeah.
Not 46, not 48,
some willy-nilly number.
The sun is up. We have work to do.
Yes, people to endure.
What?
People to serve, Mr. Walker.
Look, we have to get the new Epsom salt display up. It's Christmas Eve, you know.
Yes, Mr. Walker. What's Christmas Eve without Epsom salts?
It's good for what ails you.
I doubt it.
Well,
ladies.
Hello. A beautiful day.
Yes, ma'am, it is.
And how's the missus and the baby?
Yes.
We are all fine, thank you.
Oh, good.
It's great.
Yes, well, how many weeks along now?
Well, we've got 9 or so left. If you'll excuse me, ladies, I have lunch with my wife.
Oh.
We're going to have a picnic.
Oh, how romantic.
Oh, gracious. How chilly.
Oh, hi, picnic. It's very romantic.
Oh, goodness gracious.
Oh, there's the little mother.
She certainly is a mother to be.
Oh, gracious. Hello.
Oh, goodness. See how high she's carrying it?
Yeah.
It's going to be a boy. I just know it is.
Oh, I think it's a girl. She doesn't have a glow. You glow when you're going to have a boy, and she doesn't have a glow.
Oh, well, I agree with Cleo. Look
yes.
how high
well,
she's
thank
carrying
you.
It.
Gracious, any higher, it'd be your Adam's apple. Oh, look at that.
Well, we better be going.
Yes,
we better be off.
Oh, yes, we're off.
Just a little.
Oh, sweetheart, the baby kicked. Feel.
Oh, that's all right.
I thought a nice picnic would be perfect. It's a beautiful, sunny day, warm.
Well, now I only have 45 minutes. Mr. Walker wants me back in the coal mine.
Oh, Rufus, call him Dad.
Ginger, I just can't bring myself to do that.
I know that's what he wants.
Oh, I'll think about it.
Tried some new recipes today. I think you'll like them.
Oh, no, not another batch of grass sandwiches.
I'm just thinking about the baby. Now we've discussed this.
You're right. Okay.
Speaking of which, thought of a name if it's a girl.
Rufus Jr.?
Very funny. No, as a matter of fact, I was thinking Jennifer. Mm. You really have your heart set on a boy, don't you?
Well, I figured since my life doesn't seem to be going anywhere, I could live vicariously through him.
Rufus, I wish I could make you realize you've achieved so much already, and I am very proud of you. And besides, what makes you think a daughter couldn't achieve great things?
Well, let me take my foot out of my mouth and I'll answer you.
Well, I hope it is a girl. She can wear the christening dress that I wore. I've spoken to Pastor Martin about it and, well, whatever God gives us will be fine.
Absolutely, as long as it's a boy.
Oh, you may be right. It feels like a game of kickball is going on inside of me. I just love Christmas. Do you realize 7 Christmases ago, we were standing right in the middle of some crazy soundstage. And now here we are, happy, our baby on the way. Isn't it just wonderful? Next year we'll be a family of 3 and maybe even, who knows, 3 and a half.
Oh, slow down there. Let's just take care of this one first.
Okay, but in a couple of years, Dad will retire and the business will be all yours. We can buy a house of our own and fill it with kids. That is what you want, isn't it?
Yeah. I'll be the typical upstanding citizen. The average Joe with 2.5 kids and playing stickball on the weekends.
Somehow when you say it, it doesn't seem quite as wonderful as it should be. Playing with children would do you good, Rufus Miller. It may even help you recapture your innocence of youth, if you ever had it at all.
Well, we'd better eat. Pass me a shrub.
Oh, Rufus.
She's so demurely chewing on her watercress souffle, while I'm quietly stewing on my life within a masquerade. This smile is hard to maintain. I feel politely insane. It's calling me, a tom-tom drum in my brain. But she sees nothing. She sees nothing wrong. I wrestle both day and night for something wrong, something right. They're calling me, yet here I stand in her eyes. And she sees nothing. She sees nothing. I should be up on my feet, a man made complete, a high wire star. Up there it's never how slow a fella can go, only how far. Nothing, only nothing. I should be up on my feet, a man made complete, a high wire star. Up there it's never how slow a fella can go, only how far. Struggle and strain against this solo campaign. It's calling me, it's sure she'll never complain, for she sees nothing. For she sees nothing. I am nothing, but she sees nothing wrong.
You've hardly touched your sandwich, Rufus.
Oh, I'm sorry. I guess I'm just not very hungry.
What's wrong?
Nothing.
Just doesn't seem like Christmas without Jennifer. This was her favorite Christmas show.
I thought we weren't going to be talking about this.
I can't help it. I pray she's all right. You know, this never gets any easier.
I know, but she's old enough to make her own decisions.
She was born old. She's always been so serious, just like her father. You know, it was like I never had a little girl. She never had any of that blind, childlike innocence.
Hello? What? I'll be right there. I've got to go. Someone has vandalized the drugstore.
Jennifer, I'm so glad we got you to come down and join us tonight. It's not a very fun way to spend Christmas, but it's for a great cause.
No problem, Rick. I'm not really into the Christmas scene anyway.
You're not? Why is that?
Well, Christmas at my house with my mom and dad is not exactly my cup of tea. See, as hard as mom tries, my dad couldn't care less. And they just don't get this war, and all we do is fight over it. See, my dad's a World War II veteran, and he's let his patriotism blind him to this insanity. I got tired of all the fighting and moved in with a friend about 10 months ago. My dad would freak if he knew I was here. Besides, I don't really feel like celebrating Christmas with the world like it is anyway. Rick, life is just a garbage sandwich, and every day is just another bite. People are dying out there. I mean, if God is there, how could he let...
People are doing it, Jen, not God. With all the worst downers with this war, there's always one sure thing. God will always be hanging tough with you. Unfortunately, God gets the bad rap for a lot of things that people do. I think he's as frustrated as we are.
Maybe. I never thought about it that way. My mom's always been the churchgoer in the family. My dad's never gone, and I quit when I was about 13.
Oh, I know I need him, especially in times like these. Would you like to go to dinner sometime? Maybe a movie?
Maybe. Well, everybody breaks over.
No more war. 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 No more war.
That has to be them, officer.
No more war.
Those hoodlums egged my store and broke my sign just because I had an American flag and an Uncle Sam poster in the window. What have we here? A meeting of Santa's elves?
No more Nixon! No more war!
Okay, enough already. The party's over. Go home.
We know our rights. Freedom of assembly.
Yeah!
Assembly's one thing. Destruction of private property is another.
We didn't break his stupid sign.
Funny, I didn't say anything about a sign. That's it. Either leave now or you're headed downtown.
Smooth dipstick.
No, come on, everybody. Forget it. We won't go. Come on.
We won't go. We won't go. We won't go.
Jennifer? You know this guy? I'm her father.
Unfortunately.
Okay, enough. Break it up. Go home. This isn't going to solve anything.
I'll see you later, Jen.
Your mother misses you.
Same old warm and cuddly dad.
I miss you too. I don't want to fight. Of course I miss you.
Dad, you know it won't work with us. We're just too different.
Maybe too much alike.
I just can't imagine why anyone would choose to go to war. My friends are over there right now getting killed, and there's no way that you would understand that. You weren't drafted, you enlisted. You wanted to go over there and kill people.
Sometimes war isn't a choice. I didn't go so I could kill people. I went so I could save people. I went so you could have the right to protest the very system that I fought to protect.
I'll never understand you. You're impossible.
Do you remember me? I sat upon your knee. I wrote to you of childhood fantasies. Well, I'm all grown up now, but still need help somehow. I'm not a child, but my heart still can dream. So here's my lifelong wish, my grown-up Christmas list, not for myself, but for a world in need. No more lives torn apart, and wars would never start, and time could heal all hearts. And everyone would have a friend, and right would always win, and love would never end. This is my grown-up Christmas list. As children we believe the grandest sight to see is something lovely wrapped beneath the tree. But heaven surely knows that packages and bows can never heal a hurting human soul. No more lives torn apart, and wars would never time could heal all harms. And everyone would have a friend, and right would always win, and love would never end. This is my grown-up Christmas list. What is this illusion called? The innocence of youth. Maybe only in our blind belief can we ever find the
Daddy.
I'm sorry too, baby. I'm so sorry.
No more lives torn apart, and wars will never start, and time will heal. Everyone would have a friend, and right would always win, and love would never end.
This is my grown-up Christmas list.
This is my only lifelong wish. This is my grown-up Christmas list.
Let's go home. Your mother's worried sick.
Okay, people, we've got to hurry. The doors are going to open in, oh my goodness, 5 minutes. We have a couple of quick things we have to go over, places.
Angels, we have heard on high, sweet is he in all the plains, and on our answering fire, echoing their joyous ring.
Okay, no. Angels, that's not singing sweetly o'er the plains. How can the mountains reply to that? Imagine what those angels must have sounded like that night, and then make the most beautiful sound that you possibly can make. Okay, we have to keep moving. Okay, now shepherds, during this next verse, I want you to walk slowly but jubilantly across to center stage. Okay? Shauna, pitches please.
Shepherds, why this jubilee? Why your joyous praises?
Stop. Shepherds, is that what you call jubilant? You got to remember, you're on your way to see the Christ child. Imagine what those shepherds were feeling and then act it out. Okay? We've got to keep moving. Wise men, let's move to your entrance. Shauna, 4 measures, please.
Yeah.
Okay, very nice, very nice. Okay, look, I'm going to give you a 5-minute break. But before we do, come on, let's have a word of prayer. Kind Heavenly Father, we pray that you'll be with us tonight as we humbly attempt to retell the story of your son's birth. Make us worthy vessels. We pray, Lord, that there will be a soul that's here tonight that will be touched, that they will come to accept your great gift of love. We ask these things in your son's precious name. And everybody said,
Amen. Amen.
Okay, let's go. 5 minutes.
Are you sure you should be out here in your condition?
I'll be fine. This way we'll get a good seat.
Well, Rick's in the show, isn't he? Why couldn't he score us some seats so we wouldn't have to wait out here in the cold?
Dad, it's a church, not a sports arena. You don't score seats. It's first come, first served.
You know, this is the first time he's been in church since we've been married.
Yeah, I hope the structure's sound. It may not be able to handle the likes of me. I'd hate for it to cave in on us.
I'm willing to take my chances. I'm so happy to have you both here. I'm really going to need the help when the baby comes. I'm glad it worked out that you could all be here to see Rick's big stage debut.
Lucky break. You know, I have to admit, I am a little nervous about this.
For heaven's sake, about what?
Well, they're not going to drag me up front and dunk me or make me drink chicken blood, are they?
Of course they are. It's church. I'm just kidding. That was fun. Is that what you think I do every week when I go to church?
Well, I have no idea. All I know is that when there's a dinner, a chicken is involved.
Oh, here we go.
Best wise man I've ever seen.
Thanks. Dad, I'm really glad you could come tonight.
Well, so am I. I'm glad to see that somebody in the family finally became an actor and made something of himself. I was a little disappointed, though.
Why is that, dear?
No chickens.
Oh! What is it? Are you okay?
I don't know. It really hurts. Oh!
I'll get the car.
Mom! Something's not right. I'm really scared.
It'll be okay. We will get you to the hospital in no time.
God, if you're there, help my little girl. Please, God.
You a cutie, with your little berry nose. Holly Seach suits you to a T. You look
Dr.
a lot
Davis,
like your mommy.
Telephone, please. Dr. Davis, telephone, please.
There you
you are.
Where's Rick?
He's taking care of some last-minute paperwork.
Well, I'll go get him and tell him that we're ready to go home.
Here you go. She's a beauty.
She's the most beautiful thing I've ever laid eyes on.
These last couple of days have been doozies.
They certainly have. Dad, are you okay? You seem like you're someplace else.
I'm sorry. I guess I've just got a lot on my mind. That's all.
Well, do you want to talk about something?
Well, I can't help thinking what a fool I've been. I've spent my entire life being miserable, trying to be something I'm not. I'll never be a hero or have my name in a history book. My face will never be on the big screen, and I'll never be a big-shot politician. But what's so strange is, for the first time in my life, I don't care, and I'm not sure why.
Maybe it's because for the first time in your life, you're realizing that those things are not what matter. Those things will all fade.
You must think your old man's quite the fool, huh?
I'll admit, I used to. We've never exactly seen eye to eye on things, but I do love you.
Do you think there's hope for an old fool like me?
There's always hope if we live for God. No one can take him away. He is our hope.
I've heard those words before. I remember it like it was yesterday. Faith like I've never seen. An old woman whose family had taken me in when I was injured during the war. She said those very words to me.
Those words are true, Dad. So, what's next? You think God has forgotten all the great things you wanted when you were a kid, but you have to ask yourself, is it possible that his memory is better than yours? Is it possible that his idea of greatness is different than yours?
All done. You guys ready?
There's my precious girl. You made Daddy the luckiest man alive. Yes, you have.
Come on, Grandpa. Let's get these kids home.
You go on ahead. I'll be there in a minute.
Okay.
Front of that church, and you held up your end, so I'll hold up mine. I may not be much of a man, but I'm all yours. You must be so patient to have waited this long for me. All the times you must have tried to show me things I could not see. Foundations you have laid
and pathways you have made. But I was busy walking fast the other way. I beg to be forgiven. I'm told you find it in your heart to take me just as I am, leaving nothing to my charge, but wipe the canvas clean and paint a brand new scene. You are the author and the artist of my destiny. I come, I pray it's not too late. I come with nothing but a trace of hope that you can fill me and trust that you can heal me. I don't know what to do, but I come in simple faith. Lord, you've got my attention. You've given me the perfect sign. God, I see your reflection in the eyes of a little child. It brings me to my knees, and I can hardly God, I don't know what to do, but reach out to you. I come, I pray it's not too late. I come with nothing but a trace of hope that you can fill me and trust. I don't know what to do, so I come in simple faith.
Oh, come, let us adore Him as the Lord. Oh, come, let us adore Him as the Lord.
So then God was happy with his son, baby Jesus, and when Jesus grew up, he met his disciples and Poppy Rufus too. Then everyone told about God in heaven. The end.
Good. Did you hear that, Dad? You've been elevated to disciple now.
No higher honor, Pumpkin. No higher honor. I wish Ginger could have heard that story. Now, she would have loved it. It's been 11 years since she's been gone, and I miss her just like it was yesterday.
We all miss her, Poppy.
So where did Megan get the idea that Poppy was a disciple?
She came up with that on her own, I promise.
All I did was tell her that Poppy and Jesus share the same birthday, and she came up with the rest.
She was telling me something about Dad being a strong man in the circus. Where did she come up with that?
I have no idea on that one. She just has a vivid imagination, right, Megan?
Yep, my imagination is vivid.
Well, I don't know about the rest of you, but it's getting late and it's way past my bedtime.
Oh my gosh, it's almost midnight. We have to get to bed before Santa comes. Tomorrow's Christmas Day and Poppy Rufus's birthday.
And yours too, honey. Remember that, Dad? It was quite a night, wasn't it? The start of something great.
It certainly was.
Anyways, Mom and Dad, you two can sleep upstairs in Megan's room, and Poppy, I'll get your bed in the guest room turned down, and Megan, you go on upstairs with Daddy. You can sleep with us.
But can I stay here with Poppy until you're done, please?
Oh, come on. At least till you get my room ready.
Okay, but then off to bed, sweetie.
Okay, Mommy.
Are you excited about Santa Claus coming?
Do you know him too, Poppy?
Why, I sure do. He and I are best friends.
Poppy! We forgot the star! Santa won't want to come without the star, Poppy!
It's so contagious that never a tear can remain while singing notes.